And may Allah reward Brother Rana. He brought us some of the flyers from last year, which we will be distributing inshallah ta'ala. And this is like we did every single year. This is a suggested schedule of how to spend our day in Ramadan. All the things, everything is 100% authentic as usual. And the title of the brochure, it could be my last. This could be my last Ramadan. So I want to make sure that I take advantage of every single moment. Adam. We have a little kid here. Go to the sister's side. Yeah, come. Okay, sisters, this young man is going to extend his hand. Just take it from him, inshallah. Just put your hand through the door and the sisters will take it away from you. If you need more, let me know. Bismillah, alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillah. So, mashallah, this year is colored also. Jazakallah khair, brother. So this year, and he's been printing it for the past few years. You could also take one and print and distribute. You never know. Just like Brother Griffin, nobody knows he's going to become a Muslim, subhanallah. So we just do the khair, we plant the seeds, and we leave it to Allah Azza wa Jal, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is a program from the moment we wake up till the moment we go back to sleep. Things that most of us know already. It's just a reminder. It's just a reminder because the reminder benefits the believers. May Allah make us all from the believers. طيب. So we start by waking up in the morning. Let's go through it quickly, inshallah. I'm gonna finish at 10:10, inshallah ta'ala. So 10 minutes and we will continue next week. Please make sure, don't forget it next week and ask for another one. I'm gonna charge you $5 to the masjid. Yani. Bring it with you next week also. So before we get up in the middle of the night, sometimes we go to sleep, and in the middle of the night you get up, you want to drink water, you want to use the restroom for any reason. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whoever gets up at night and says, wallahi this dua, subhanallah, is amazing. لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد وهو على كل شيء قدير. This part you all know. Alhamdulillah, subhanallah, alhamdulillah, subhanallah, la ilaha illallah, wallahu akbar, wala hawla wala quwwata illa billah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa said, whomsoever says that, and then he says, Allahumma ghfirli. Listen carefully. I get up in the middle of the night. This is different than alhamdulillah ladhi ahyana ba'dama amatana wa ilayhi nushur. This is different. This is you get up in the middle of the night, which is going to happen because we are getting up for suhoor, right? So I get up, I'm sitting on the edge of the bed. La ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lah, lahul mulk wa lahul hamd, wa huwa ala kulli shay'in qadir. Alhamdulillah, subhanallah, la ilaha illallah, Allahu akbar, wa la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah, Allahumma ghfirli. What happens? Or he makes any dua. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, he says, Allahumma ghfirli, or invokes, يعني da'a, thumma da'a, Ya Allah, protect my children. Ya Allah, grant me Jannah. Ya Allah, accept Siyam from me. Ya Allah, make Qiyam easy for me. Whatever, he made any dua, what happens? He will be responded to, and if he performs wudu, and he prayed, that salat is accepted. Allahu Akbar. And the hadith is in Bukhari. Yani, you know, when we perform salat, this salat we just performed right now, if you know it was accepted, raise your hand. Exactly. This one, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, if you go through this process, that salat is accepted. لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، له الملك وله الحمد وهو على كل شيء قدير. الحمد لله، سبحان الله، لا إله إلا الله، الله أكبر، لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله، اللهم اغفر لي. And then ثم دعا. The dua will be accepted. The dua will be answered, responded to. Imagine, ya akhwan, this hadith is in Bukhari, 100% authentic. The dua is answered and the salat, if he makes wudu. You know, because at that time, we all know, and this all happened to all of us. At that time, you can't wait to drink that water, to use that restroom, and what? And what? Go back to sleep. That's why this reward is huge. Who's going to make wudu at that time? Allahu Akbar. Needs men. You know? Subhanallah. So this is really a challenge. Really a challenge. Now in Ramadan, it's a little bit easier. Because, you know, I'm going to get up. Maybe I'll pray 2 rak'ah. Qiyam. I will wait till suhoor. I come to pray Fajr in Jama'ah. So the jaw of Ramadan, that shaitan who told me go back to sleep, he's chained. So in Ramadan, it's easier to apply this. And by the way, everything I'm mentioning here is not only for Ramadan. Just to be trained in Ramadan so we can perform all through the year. Okay? Second, the hadith we mentioned in the khutbah. We all know this hadith. Rasulullah said, when we all go to sleep, the shaitan comes on the back of our neck and he makes 3 knots. And on each knot, the shaitan makes a dua or makes a statement. Sleep, sleep. You have a long night. Nam. Huh? Keep sleeping. You have very long nights. Fajr is at 6. By the way, tomorrow is Fajr. We forgot to announce. We're very excited. Tomorrow Fajr at 6 a.m. Tomorrow Fajr at 6 a.m. So the shaitan comes and, you know what? It's 5:30. There's half an hour till 6 o'clock. Sleep. And then he wakes up 5:45. Today is Jumu'ah. Sheikh Sajjad is going to read Sajda and Insan 20 minutes. So you will catch Rak'ah. Sleep. How many times it happened to you? The brothers, do you know the shaitan? You know, sleep, sleep. And then all of a sudden, you open one eye, the sun is up. راح الفجر وراح كل شيء. Subhanallah. So, when we, Rasulullah SAW said, the minute you get up, any dua, ذكر الله, فانحلت عقدة, ذكر الله, Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah, La ilaha illallah, this dua, one knot is gone. Wudu, second knot is gone. Salat, third knot is gone. فكان نشيط. He will be full of energy the whole day. طيب النفس. Beautiful soul. Very happy. And if he didn't, then subhanallah. كان خبيث النفس كسلان, right? كان خبيث النفس كسلان. He was sluggish, lazy, and has a very bad نفس. يعني. He's not happy at all. And the whole day is very lazy. Subhanallah. Subhanallah. So, you know, remember Allah Azza wa Jal, remembering Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala will get rid of one knot, wudu, and then 2 rak'ah will take care of all these three knots. Okay. Now, third, see. Subhanallah. I mention this all the time. Every single year, a brother comes to me and he thinks that he's doing something very good. Said, Ustaz, no suhoor, 16 hours. يعني he's like, you know, he's like, you know who you're talking to? No suhoor. Habibi, no suhoor is no good. Even if you can handle 17, 18 hours, inna fi suhoor baraka. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, there is baraka in the suhoor. No matter how small it is or how big it is, Allah will put baraka in it. And then you will feel very strong the whole day. إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى الْمُتَسَحِّرِينَ. Allah and His angels send their blessings for the people who perform suhoor. Or they said, متسحرين means the people who remember Allah at suhoor. But it also could mean the people are having suhoor. Anyway, the time of sahar in general is that time. Before Fajr, وَالْمُسْتَغْفِرِينَ بِالْأَسْحَارِ. The one who make istighfar at the time of ashar. When the time of ashar is, the time of suhoor, is the last time before fajr. So, إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ سَيُصَلُّونَ عَلَى الْمُتَسَحِّرِينَ Hadith is sahih. Subhanallah. So, ya akhi, one date, one sip of water. If you don't, if some people get really bothered by suhoor. You know, some people, their stomach, you know, they eat something in the morning, it bothers them a lot. So, just a sip of water to apply the sunnah. Just a sip of water to get the barakah. Okay? I know some brothers, mashallah, yalla, al-biryani, with chicken, with cow's feet, and all that stuff. But subhanallah, I don't know how can you handle that, ya akhu. Yani, some cereal and something simple, and should be, inshallah. And the sunnah is to make suhoor on few dates. And inshallah ta'ala, this was the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That's all they had, subhanallah. Some dates and some halib, some leban, some milk, and that should be sufficient. Let's take one more, inshallah. Now, everybody, inshallah ta'ala, everybody, like I said in the khutbah, every single one of us, ya akhwan, is going to make a promise that every single fajr is in the masjid. No more praying at home, please, ya akhwan. Let's make Ramadan as a training field for fajr in jama'ah. MashaAllah, I'm looking at you and all of you, MashaAllah, I'm seeing that you are from the Fajr people already. So, let's keep doing that and add to it, like I said, add to it, inshaAllah, that every single day we're going to stay till Shuruq. If your time permits and your schedule permits, please make, subhanAllah, Hajj in Ramadan, ya akhwan. Hajj in Ramadan, Allahu Akbar. Yani everything in Ramadan is multiplied. How about this 1 hour I sacrifice of my time to get the ajr of Hajj and Umrah? So when I leave to the masjid, Rasulullah said, the reward of the deeds depend on the intention. And every person will get the reward according to what he intends. Why did I mention this hadith here? إِنَّمَا الْأَعْمَالُ بِالنِّيَّاتِ Why did I put this hadith under walking to the masjid? Because we want, like I always mention, to make a tijara with intentions. Ya Allah, I'm walking to the masjid to get the ajr of 27 times. Every step, hasan is rewarded, sayyi is erased, one status is elevated. I'm going to meet my brothers and say salamu alaykum. With every salamu alaykum, there's tons of hasanat. I'm going to do this. All that extra intentions to add to our scale, bi'ithnillah. So, make few intentions before you leave to the masjid. And I'll take one more B. Bismillah, tawakkaltu ala Allah, wa la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. Ya akhwan, this is not only for leaving to Fajr. This is any time you leave the house, any time your children go to school, any time. Teach them this simple dua. Bismillah, tawakkaltu ala Allah, wa la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. What happens? What happens when I do that? Listen to this, read. It will be said to him, it will be said to him, you are guided, defended, and protected. Allahu Akbar. Bismillah, tawakkaltu ala Allah, wa la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. Less than 10 seconds, full coverage, insurance, full coverage the whole day. You have been protected, guided, and defended. And the shayateen will go far from him, and one devil will tell the other, how can you deal with a man who has been guided, defended, and protected? Leave him alone. Allahu Akbar. Just because we said, Bismillah, tawakkaltu ala Allah, wa la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. Forgive me, I extended 2 more minutes, inshallah ta'ala. You can deduct it from next time. And inshallah, please bring this with you next week, inshallah ta'ala. We will continue. I will have some more, so you can have more brothers, inshallah. Subhanak Allahumma bihamdik. Nashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. Nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk. If you want to take some to your family members, you are more than welcome, inshallah.